We have Microtech Amphibian. I think this will be the latest from Microtech. They come in these lovely Microtech bags. And then also do include a Microtech nylon sheath. You can wear horizontal or sideways on the belt. Check out this froggy green Amphibian. This is the manual version, no button. These are stonewashed finish. A ceramic tumbled finish, which is nice and shiny, but if you get a scratch on this, you're not going to see it, because it's got this nice stonewash finish that that really seals the blade against rust better than a bead blast finish, definitely. So it's got a ball bearing detent. I'll just slurp in the rest of the way by itself. Ambidextrous thumb studs. Left hand or the right, and this kind of neat mechanism that they came up with to replace the liner lock, where it's a spring-loaded bar. I think that's a patented mechanism that you can see on the IBM patent site. There's our Amphibian and manual. I'll show you the auto version. Much more exciting. With all its birth certificates there. Okay. These have the teardrop style button, the kind of the improved teardrop style button. You see, it just comes off a little bit off the face there. It was on the earlier SOCOMs, they were difficult to reach. This is a black handle, full, two Krathon inserts on the front. With a stonewashed plain edge blade vented there. These are super high tech knives. These are just amazing. This is a big pocket clip in silver that you can remove and spray paint black. We hear it costs about $4 to black tea a clip, so most makers don't do it, unfortunately, because they have to order these pocket clips 10,000 at a time, and they could probably take that money and buy a new machine or something, so they don't black tea pocket clips. There's a detail in this knife. You have these little ridges up here, so you can choke up on it, in addition to back here. Also on the back, it's got an inset lanyard hole. These look like Torx or spline drive screws. See, there's two back here. And this is, of course, a coil-fired knife. You can just barely see inside there where that button locks it and unlocks it. It's an extremely stable design. Though it does not have a safety on it, you carry it in your right pocket, pushed up against the back of the pocket, so the blade wouldn't be able to come open. And in selling tens and thousands of these, we've heard of really no time where a pocket knife or an auto ever opened in someone's pocket accidentally. Because you're just gonna know with a knife like this. It takes quite a bit of pressure to open it too. And of course it does include a nylon belt sheath. You can carry it on your belt.